Matt DeLeon, and this video is on the Lachman test. The Lachman test tests for the ACL tear or rupture. Now, before you do the Lachman test or any ACL test, experts suggest that you rule out a PCL ligament rupture or tear, since the PCL lies beneath the tibia. Since it lies beneath the tibia, any rupture or tear in the PCL can cause a lot of movement for the tibia, and this movement can make a false positive for the Lachman test. Now, to set up the Lachman test, have your patient supine with the affected leg flexed at about 20 to 30 degrees and externally rotated slightly. Now, what you want to do is to grasp the thigh with the hand closest to the patient's head and place your other hand behind the tibia, making sure that your thumb is on the tibial tuberosity. Now, stabilizing the thigh, translate the tibia anteriorly. So you want to move the tibia up towards you while you are firmly grasping the patient's thigh. Now, a positive, Now this test is positive if the patient feels a soft or mushy end feel, and additionally, the anterior translation of the leg is about 2 millimeters in comparison to the uninjured leg, and 10 millimeters overall in total anterior translation. The sensitivity for this test ranged about 63% to 93%, with the specificity being 55% to 99%. However, a meta-analysis in 2006 shows that the sensitivity and specificity of the Lachman test is about 85% and 94% respectively. This means that the test is pretty good at ruling out and ruling in an ACL tear or rupture. And that's it. Thank you.